Is Shelley really gone?
Yes, love.
Why didn't she like living with us?
She had to go. It was just one of those things.
Oh, I liked Auntie Shelley. She's done the flat up lovely. Can we go and see her?
Why don't you go and play for a bit, eh? Let me sort all this out.
Oh, Mum, this Dave's got no Shelley.
Look, it's obvious that she's not going to make the complaint. So please, can we just leave it just for tonight?
It's very easy for you to say.
Have you been like this all day? Look, just try and put it out of your mind. Nothing's going to come of it, I promise.
How do you know? I hate it when people do that. Everything's going to be all right. How do you know?
Well, I don't. I was just trying to reassure you.
Well, if she lodges a formal complaint, this could be the end of my career. It's hardly the sort of thing I'm going to forget over a few drinks.
Yeah, but you told her that you were going to sue her if she tried.
Great. A legal case. That's all I need. As a doctor, all I have is my reputation.
Even Jimmy.
Hiya, love. Hello, heartbreaker. Look at her. Isn't she getting big now? I saw the builders around at your place this morning. Dust flying everywhere. You having Dicko's hair re-sculpted, am I?
We're having the front room and kitchen knocked through. And an extension on the back.
Oh, man, that's a big job. I was not expecting you to pay up for it on your tart.
Oh, got the wrong idea about Ron. We're going 50-50.
50-50. Hey, listen, your grandma's earned her place in the history books there. Do you know that, hey? The first woman who prized open Ron Dicko's wallet.
It wasn't easy. He wanted to cut corners, but I stood my ground. The last time an amateur messed with my house, they brought the roof down, and that was Ron himself. He saw the sense in it when I pointed that out.
Love, I remember it well. See you later.
Hiya.
Hiya.
We're doing clay pots at school. Here, look, Miss Bocock showed up.
Betty Bocock?
She's not called Betty.
Well, she should be. Anyone whose surname begins with B is a Betty. It's my law. Hey, it's that good, man, isn't it, Beth? Really good heart, aren't you?
Thanks. Well, can I get back up home now? Want me tea?
Oh, I'm sorry, babe. You're going to have to hang on while I do this. Lads will make your milkshake.
Strawberry.
Mm. I'll be stuck down here all the time. No, Auntie Shelley's gone. Hey, Auntie Anthea.
Shelley's done one. Well, why?
Tell you about, you want to put this away. Keep your eye on trouble.
Look, Auntie, it's a change, love. Thanks.
Sure. Couldn't you find someone else to cover this shift with me?
Listen, I tried to get Trisha and she'd taken sick.
Yeah, well, I suppose it was only a couple of hours.
Lindsay, we can hardly avoid seeing each other. We live in the same flipping house.
For me dad's sake, that's all.
We work together.
Yeah, well, we don't have to. From now on, I don't want to work the same shifts as you. Now, I've made up a schedule, and these are the dates and times we're going to cross over. So if you could find an alternative, I'd be really grateful.
Of course, it'll be fine. You can stay at ours tonight. Give your mum a break.
You are a star. I just need to sort the flat out.
Great. Can I help put the baby to bed, Aunt Cynthia?
Don't see why not.
She's my sister. Never see her. Never have anyone to play with.
Well, you've got friends at school, haven't you?
Well, only Gary Russell, and he's weird.
When's Beth going to start talking?
Oh, not for a little while.
Are you sure about doing the bookkeeping, Al?
I'm positive. I need the extra cash.
Jimmy, meet the new bookkeeper.
Oh, well, Ronaldo, mind you helping this lady out?
Of course he will. That's why I'm doing it.
Nice one. Like your style, Beth. I'm getting off. OK, love?
OK, I'll see you later, Jimmy.
Yeah, put off.
He's not supposed to go till 1:45.
Josh, you don't run this bar, Mummy does.
Not for long, by the looks of things.
So, come on, then. What happened with Shelley?
Told you. She had the Stardust trial.
Why? Jackie Cole can finally give her the brush off.
Don't know. Got back to the flat last night and there was a note, hello, goodbye.
No reason?
No, and the worst thing was there was no more than a thank you. I mean, the hospitality I gave that girl. The nights I sat up listening to the ins and outs of her love life and trying to sort out her tangled web, she just ups and leaves.
Have you asked Lindsay?
No, I haven't seen her. You know, I thought Shelley was me mate. A proper mate.
Still, she did go a bit strange on you the past few weeks. And my mate Clayton reckons there's nothing deadlier than a cornered lesbian.
I know. She must have been a bit of a strange one to fancy old Jackie Corkill. So she wasted a young life on Ron Dixon. I reckon she'll have a lucky escape.
Hello?
Hi, Dad.
They're my two favourite girls.
Oh, you've done our teas for us?
I have, love. Toad in the hole with baked beans followed by strawberry ice cream. A reunited Corkill family tea for a reunited Corkill family.
I think I'll have a bit of a rest, first, love. Save mine for later, eh?
Hey, no, you don't. None of that, none of that. We are all sitting down for tea together.
Josh, can you go and wash your hands, please? Your granddad will be here in a minute.
It's okay, sir. Oh, are you still down on the dump spot, Shelley?
No. Just been thinking. In a couple of weeks, it'll be years since I've taken over this place.
Oh, well, great, let's have a party. Oh, I know, we could have a theme night. One night. And everyone has to wear something that they've only got one of.
Like what?
I don't know. Like an odd sock. Or the one and only purple shirt. Or... oh, I'm not selling this shoe, am I, babe?
Now, why wouldn't the landlady be clicking her heels at the mention of the word party?
I've forgotten. New Year's Eve.
I haven't.
Maybe we should just forget about it then.
Oh, the best day out I ever had.
No, when?
July 4th, 1986. They took all of us who were leaving school to Southport in a chowder for the day.
And on the way back, you cuddled with Jack and you opened a bottle of cider.
No, on the way back, I snogged the gob off Mark Woods and then puked in a polythene bag.
Same sentiment.
Why don't I hire a chara, right? We'll have a little out now to Southport, you know, for the anniversary. Bev's bar on the buses.
It's the dead of winter.
Ah, we won't notice. Not when we've had a few bevvies behind us.
I'll tell you, Bev's little fella thinks he's running the place. Sitting on her stool, giving out orders. He wants to take over.
Mum, if Josh does take her back, can I work there?
In another 10 years, maybe. Hey, and you can't have my job either. I don't believe in nepotism, except when it's in the family. Listen, I'm not that daft that I can't work out what's happened, you know.
We're trying, look.
You've been like this for weeks.
We haven't, Dad, honest. We're just very tired.
It's Corkill year zero. So let's just get all our secrets out in the open, shall we? Is it to do with Shelley? I know something's going on. And I want to know what it is.
I'd like to speak with your sister, please.
Leanne is unavailable.
Not pulled herself out of her trough, then?
If you're going to use abusive language, then I'm going to have to ask Sue to leave the bar.
She could ruin Darren's career.
And spare other women going through the same ordeal. It takes a lot of bravery to speak out, you know.
Lance, I can't understand why you believe her. You're a nice guy, you're not stupid.
Don't patronise me.
Jackie has told me all about her. She was a prostitute. She went to prison for spraying acid in Jackie's face.
Yeah, well, that's the twisted version. Oh, people like you think you can trample all over people like us. Wrong. You don't frighten us anymore.
Well, one day you'll see her for what she is, and I hope it's coming soon.
Oh, you're not going to believe this. That Victorian one's been in again, stirring up more trouble. Bev, what's wrong? What's the matter, babe?
I'm all right. You go back to the bar.
I'm not leaving you in this state.
First Dave, then Shelley. What is it about me, eh? People just can't wait to use me and then get away.
Oh.
Still don't get it. And I saw Shelley a couple of days ago and she seemed right as rain.
I think she just didn't want any big farewells.
Hang on. I'm trying to work this out. You had a thing with Shelley and you disapproved, right? So did you drive her away? Is that what this is all about?
Of course I did.
She helped me, you know, Linz. Came to see me in the Aussie, one of the few that did, and I'm counting the people I've known for years.
I suppose.
No, there's no suppose about it. She went against the grain of how people are today. She was interested, she cared about her mates. She took the time, she cared about this family and all of us.
Can you just give it a rest, please, Dad?
All right, love, I'm sorry. I know it's painful. You know how I think she viewed you?
Sort of.
She was looking for a proper mother. Her own was a white ogre by the sound of it.
I'm going to bed.
No, you're not. It's time that you two had this all out. We're going to work through this.
Time for the last time. Ladies and gentlemen, can you start making your way outside, please? Thank you. Hey, you. Leave off the cleaners in the morning. I want to lock up.
Beverly, are you still upset about Shelley?
Stuff Shelley.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So what's the matter then? You can tell me, you know, whatever it is.
Do you really want to know?
Yeah, I do.
Look, it's nothing. I'll be fine in the morning.
Yeah, you'll be fine in the morning. But whatever it is will come creeping back and you'll feel just as bad all over again.
Yeah, well, that's my lookout.
Right, am I going to have to get forceful?
Glad to see you try.
Lock those doors and turn off the lights. I'm going to get us a couple of drinks. I've just declared a lock-in. And even if it takes all night, I'm going to get it out of you.
See you tomorrow.
Nice. Jackie, love, I'm sorry for what I'm going to say, and I don't want to upset you or me, but you've really surprised me here with your attitude.
My attitude to what?
Your attitude to Lindsay and Shelley. Look, I know the thought. Have two women together knocks you sick. And to be honest, it does me too. But you have got to accept that it happened. And it might happen again. Our Lindsay is an adult. What happens if she gets another girlfriend? Or gets back with Shelley?
Well, that's hardly likely after all the damage she did.
Hang on, love. What is it you're saying? Your mother did not break you up. She says she did not make Shelley go away. She only did what she did because she cares about you, loves the bones of you.
Oh, right. That's why she did what she did.
Of course! Am I missing something here or what?
Come on then, babe.
It's daft.
Tell me.
Well, it is connected to Shelley and Dave getting off.
Go on.
Well, the last few weeks, all I've been able to think about is Dave and how I was going to get me revenge constantly.
That's only natural. And it sounds like you did, chucking his Charlie down the loo.
You think that was a good idea?
Mm. Bev, when you told me, I was so proud of you. You follow the fellow who fleeced you and you turn the tables. That is pure class.
And not pure trash.
How do you mean?
Well, it was one big tacky gesture. And as per usual, I went in, I did something without thinking, and did it make me feel any better? No.
Then you ought to go to the police about him.
What? Get it dragged out into the public? How he fleeced me cash and bought his drugs? I look like an even bigger idiot.
So that's what the problem's been?
Nah, but, well, since Shelley's gone, it's just made me realise that the person I've ignored has been most upset by Dave going.
Who?
Josh. I mean, Dave is the only adult fella who's been around Josh ever.
Well, what difference does that make?
Well, kids need both parents, don't they? A mum and a dad.
Not today. And Josh is fine.
Yeah?
Yeah. Takes after you. Proper chip off the old block.
That's the problem. I mean, he hasn't got many friends at school, and since Shelley's gone, I'm the only one who's around.
Well, then, he's got the best mother in the world. And it's better one good than two bad ones.
I don't want him growing up lonely with no dad or brothers and sisters.
Aww.
He's withdrawn, he doesn't make friends easily, and I don't want him growing up with only me around.
Of course. Staring me in the face. You want another kid, don't you?
I'm sorry I kicked off earlier.
It's okay. How can it be right that someone like Leanne can just wander in and ruin everything they've worked so hard for?
It's the position that my job puts me in. Some people want to put video cameras in surgeries or have chaperones for their female patients.
That's ridiculous. Mm.
Well, she's got to withdraw the accusation. What's up?
Well, even if she does drop the case, then what? What are people going to say? That she was too scared to carry on, or didn't want to relive her ordeal, or that I intimidated her? Whatever.
So actually, the only way out is if she admits that she's lied.
Can you see her doing that?
Find a good fella, Beth. And you'll have another kid, you will.
No way, I'm off fellas for good.
That's what Leanne says. And after the losers she's had.
Oh, she can look after herself if anyone can.
Oh, you're joking, aren't you? Oh, Leanne is so easily led astray. I mean, look at her and that dirty doctor.
Well, I know she's family and everything, but really.
Oh, she's had a hard life.
So tell me.
No, I don't like talking about it.
Oh, come on, you get cagey about your past.
Well, first you got me dad. Thankfully, he was in the army.
The army?
Used to come home about every 3 months. Oh, he'd be loaded down with presents, acting the perfect father. He'd have a few pints and, well, it would all start.
Never used to belt you, did he?
Me, my mum, or Leanne. Oh, Leanne just used to stand there. Do you know that defiant face she has?
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's how she got it, standing up to him.
What did your mum used to say?
Nothing. I don't know what she wanted out of life, but it certainly wasn't kids. Oh, she loved them, though, I'll give her that. And I suppose they must have been happy to start off with. And me and Leanne came along and we ruined it.
Oh, way, come here. I never knew all of this.
It's made me realise one thing, though. If I ever have kids, they will be the most wanted, precious things.
How'd you figure that out, though? I mean, you're not likely to be a father, are you?
I've heard there's only one way.
Well, yeah, but...
I know loads of gay blokes who've got kids. Actually, it's Fred who's most keen about it. I've got my doubts.
Yeah?
Goes back to the same thing, really. Why do we want kids? Like when you see people with babies and they're all wrapped up in Tommy colours. It's like they're a fashion accessory. I've seen gay blokes raised with kids. And you think, are they doing this just for themselves? Do they know how difficult that kid's life's going to be? You know, at school and that.
You mean getting bullied?
Oh, it'd be murder.
But kids, they don't know anything about gays and lesbians or whatever.
No, I know they don't. That's why they talk about it all the time.
You're willing to do it for Fred?
I'd do anything for Fred. And his attitude is, if we do it, then that's it. Sign our lives away. The kid comes first forever.
Did you have many fellas before him?
I had the track record of flaming Chi-Chi. Years and years of nothing. I never thought I'd find what I wanted. Fred walked into the Lisbon, and 5 minutes later, I realised I never had a bloody clue what I wanted.
Oh, that is so romantic.
Oh, don't start.
Oh, no, what you said then. They are sincere romantic words, and you meant them, and... I don't think any straight bloke could ever say anything like that. Well, to me, anyway.
Oh, Bev.
No, that's why I know I'll never have any more kids, because, well, you've got to have a good fella, haven't you? And I know they're out there, but not for me.
Yeah, that's what I used to think. And now I've got Fred. You never know what is around the next corner.
No, I do. A loser, and another loser, then another loser.
Oh, so you've had a string of bad luck?
No. I mean, I used to think it was bad luck, but, well, you get to a point in your life where you're stacked against the odds, aren't you? Nah, it's not bad luck. It's me. Me and Josh.
You will find someone, Bev. You've got too much love in you. Hey, and as someone very wise once said, mating is better than hating.
Oh, is that in the Bible?
No, Lindsay de Gaulle.
Here we are. Rock bottom tragedies. We got them remedies. Why don't we run them out and start again?
Oh, she was the one with the spot, wasn't she?
Beauty spot. She was the Madonna of the 70s. And of course, if you count Debbie Harry as the Madonna of the 80s. Which you wouldn't, so I don't even know why I said that. You are boggart.
Oh, you are the best fella in the world. You're my best mate ever.
Go sturdy.
Oh, wish I was your sister.
Yeah? Thanks.
What for?
I thought you were going to let something out down there.
What if I had? Perhaps I should have. I mean, after all, nothing happened.
Listen, we ran Shelley out for your dad's sake. If you carry on like this, he'll get to know the truth sooner or later.
What are you saying?
We've got to get along. Oh, what was the point of getting rid of Shelley?
Things can never be the same, but we're going to pretend that they are. Is that what you're saying?
We've got no choice. Okay.
You know, it's weird, isn't it?
What is?
Well, you and Fred need a woman, and I need a man.
I reckon we get out there and we start looking.
Ah, maybe we don't need to look. We could have a baby.
Yeah, the only work we're really getting through the books is glamour. Now I'm talking top end of the market.
Shall I tell you how I felt? I felt like smacking your face the way you've ignored me these past few weeks.
You want a baby? I'll give you a baby.
Rewind a minute.
Are in motion for a huge new storyline. Brookside continues tomorrow at 8. Next tonight, does size matter? Driven's on all fours next to test the staying power of the mini MPV.
Toaster won't bite you, Leon.
What's up? You're not sick enough for something, are you?
No, migraine.
Hangover.
I was on tonic, mostly, I think. Leon, that better not be what I think it is.
What?
You'd better not be signing on.
Oh, no?
They'll throw the key away after last time.
It's the council tax, Mr. Smarty Pants.
You know, it's bad enough with that Victoria one being on the warpath.
It's the council tax. Why'd you have to be so suspicious?
You turn up with a gyro-shaped envelope. With your track record, I'm gonna think, duh, it's a gyro.
Yeah, well, that's migraine for you. It blurs your vision. Hiya.
Hello. Corn dog. That for our Steve?
Mm-hmm.
Good job, Mungry. He's making do with a tongue sandwich from Trona.
What time did you get in last night?
I don't know, I was welcomed.
I never seem to see him these days.
He's in love, isn't he?
Yeah, right.
Who puts empty packets back in the fridge?
Three guesses. I'll make an omelette.
Make me a roast dinner if you like, I'm in no rush to get back.
Is it really that bad?
Very slow. Surprisingly few female patients.
Still?
Well, I wasn't hungry, really. So, come on, Steve. Spill. Did you go the full Monty, you know, matching collar and cuffs?
What?
Leon!
Well, it's all the rage in the States. Pearson is past it, they're into dying now, down below. Leopard prints, polka dots, all kinds. Or just plain blonde.
This is sexual harassment.
Oh, behave yourself. It's only the way you fellas have been speaking for years.
Not about you, Leon.
Well, you blew your tip there.
Yeah, like I'm bothered.
No, but Lance might be. Or Julie split his tips. Is he feeling any better, by the way?
Oh, Bev, no. I mean, he must be really ill, because it's not like Lance to take a sickie. I mean, even that time when he had the dart stuck in his head, he was back at school by playtime. Me nan, oh, she was a terrible shot. Anyway, you've only got yourself to blame.
Oh, yeah?
Well, I yeah, just up till all hours like a pair of giddy kibbers. You'll know better next time. I'm telling you, Bev, if our Lance, if he doesn't get his full 8 hours, he's used to neither man nor beast. Puts on at 8:30 and keep an eye on the meatloaf. What are you grinning at? Do we need an excuse?
Suppose not.
Oh, you're not thinking it's going to be an announcement?
No.
No, love. It's just a meal, that's all.
Oh. Now go on. Get peeling.
All right.
Someone's been singing your praises lately.
Oh, yeah.
Cheryl. She thinks you're the bee's knees. She thinks I should give you your job back.
Really?
What do you reckon?
Oh, brilliant, Di. I wouldn't let you down this time, I promise. Only, I might need a bit of time off for my modelling jobs.
How much?
I don't know exactly, but I'd make it up.
I know you would. How's all that going?
Oh, it's fantastic. I'm having a ball.
How's it really going?
The last, really. The modelling agent, Carly's gonna be quiet, not returning calls and that. So, I'll be glad for a few hours brushing up.
Gary.
Hiya.
Hi. Do you remember when we moved in and we said we weren't going to have a list of house rules because it's boring and anal?
Yeah.
It's time to get boring and anal. Cos, I've just spent an hour tidying up, okay? And this is your pile. This is mine and Darren's. This is Katie's. And this is Clint and Robbie's.
Oh, you're right. This is getting very anal.
Well, we don't mind them staying over every now and then. It's just...
Go on.
They're eating us out of house and home, Jackie. And I feel really mean saying that because it's not important, really, but it's Darren I'm worried about, with the stress of work and everything.
Yeah, but that's not our fault.
No, I know. It's Leanne's, but...
Well...
When he comes home from work, he needs to be able to just sit down and chill out and not have to worry about whether there's going to be enough hot water for him to have a bath and then having to phone for a pizza because there's nothing left to eat.
You're home early, aren't you?
Or late, depending on how you look at it.
Oh, Beverly.
How are you feeling?
Shaking.
Bit of a night last night, wasn't it?
I'll say that again. Look, I think we strayed a bit off radar.
Oh. So this migraine thing, it's all a sham then?
That's.
Yeah, it was. That's the trouble with lying to people. You start to convince yourself. That's banging.
So what, were they shooting pellets?
Yeah, I think.
But what with? A rifle, pistol, what?
Catapult.
A what?
Well, I couldn't see properly. It all happened so fast. But I think they were catapults. If we go round now, they might still be there. You might get a collar. An arrest.
Listen, it's a few kids messing about.
But there's toddlers going in and out of trainers. And old dears waiting at the bus stop. Those lads should be told. They could have someone's eye out.
Well, you'll be all right.
there's no need to hide away. You didn't make a show of yourself or anything.
I didn't.
No, you just got me thinking, and then everything kind of slotted into place.
Good.
You want a baby? I'll give you a baby.
Rewind a minute.
I know. It's obvious when you say it, isn't it? Oh, a McPowell co-production. Our very own little Dylan or Taylor or... unless you've got a name.
Bev, you're the one who's getting clocky. So it'd be me giving you the baby.
Whatever, but I mean, I wouldn't expect anything off you. And I wouldn't make any demands or come between you and Fred, no way. It could be our little secret if you wanted, and I wouldn't blow you up to the CSA or nothing. Oh, will you take that stupid thing off your head? I'm trying to talk to Top Cat. What's I saying then? I've forgotten.
You want me sperm?
Well, not just that. I want a little bit of you.
You weren't listening to a word I said last night.
All right, Leo.
Hiya.
Hiya.
How does beef stew and goose god crumble grab you? Family meal tonight. Well, your dad was saying this morning that we eat in shifts in our house. When was the last time we all sat around the table? So I thought, why not tonight?
Well, I'm taking Katrine the pictures.
Take it tomorrow.
And she doesn't eat beef, you know, with that scare and everything.
Oh, yeah. I forgot. Tell you what, let's make it a family-only meal tonight, and then you can treat her to a chicken burger after the film tomorrow. About 6:30, say.
Hey, what do you think he's a playing at? You little gets! Leo, stop them!
Nice one, Leo.
I think Neil is them. Okay, you're the one that we met.
Where do yous live? Take them straight down the cop shop.
So what are you saying? Single parents are a bad idea?
Don't be soft.
I'm not being soft. I'm just trying to make sense of it.
I'm talking about me, all right? No one else. And if I have a kid, I want to know that kid was conceived out of love and tenderness. Not for a giggle. Into the turkey baster, then back to the karaoke.
Lance?
What if they ask about their dad and they would?
Well, I'll tell them.
Well, it was a silly puff. You know what people are like. Oh, 99 was saunas and six-pack. 2000 was making babies.
That's not you.
How will they know? Oh. I don't want to be a sperm donor. I want to be a dad.
I thought that...
Yeah, I thought you knew me better than that. I thought you were better than that.
Right. Well, at least we both know where we stand.
With Jessie. Do you know, she was waiting on one for £250 last week.
Oh, I can't tomorrow. I said I go round to Cheryl's for a party.
What sort of party?
Tupperware or aloe vera. I can't really remember now. Right, come on, you lot.
Could have sunk wells in free African villages.
Could have bought a pair of trainees to last you all year.
40 pints of lager and a bag to go over your head.
What is this, give Steve stick there or something? I had that Leon one on me case in the bar this dinner. You know, I just don't get it. I look cool and she's got a face like a bag of spanners.
No, she has not.
You shouldn't mock the afflicted. Do you know, I had a suit this colour for your Auntie Moira's wedding. 9 and 11 from CNA Modes. Oh, I thought I looked like Sophia Loren.
No, it was a bit more biscuity than that. Mind you, give them the juice, son. They've kept the condition. I mean, with the peroxide that strong, it normally looks a bit like straw.
Oh, I think I preferred that when yous were slagging me off.
Trap 3 in the ladies is blocked again. Bleach.
That's fagags for you. They always let you down in the end.
Oh, I wouldn't mind a nose bag like that every night.
Wouldn't mind you cooking it. Before we get to the dishes, well, since Father Pat came round, we haven't really said much about the miscarriage. And I just wanted to say, if I've been a bit crabby or not there, I'm sorry.
Di?
Well, some of us have talked about it separately and some of us haven't mentioned it at all. And that's all right. You know, you get through these things how you can.
You mean me, don't you?
I wasn't talking about anyone in particular.
All this trouble just to have a pop. Could have done that over beans on toast.
OK, Steve, steady on.
In case you hadn't noticed, we're not the Waltons.
What?
Steve.
We don't have to go round telling each other how we feel all the time.
Well, it's just as well. We'd be waiting a long time for you, wouldn't we?
So it's not all right then?
Come on, let's leave it there.
No, Nan, it's a fair enough question.
Shall I tell you how I felt? I felt like smacking your face the way you've ignored me these past few weeks.
Come on, Di.
See? I'm not the only one who blurts out everything that comes into my head.
You hard-faced little sod.
I'm not being hard-faced. I'm not.
You could have fooled me.
Me Nan and Adele are sitting there.
Hiya.
Hi, is your Adele there?
Yeah, hang on. Is this?
Just thought I'd let you know. All sorts of lads out round on the parade. The other broke the window in Jackie Dixon's flat.
Brilliant. I mean, it's awful for Jackie, but did they do that?
Well, I had to rugby tackle one of them.
No. I wish I'd been there. I'd say come in, get my mum to put something on it for you, but we're a bit busy.
It's all right. See you later.
See ya.
You mind reading a bit, haven't you?
They know how they feel. It's obviously you don't know how you feel. That's the problem.
The last thing we need is a slanging match.
Something like this happens and he just keeps stum.
Yeah, but it's like you said. I mean, people handle things in different ways.
But it's not natural.
Look, it was your baby. He'd only known about it 5 minutes and then it had gone.
Stephen Murray.
I was upset. Of course I was upset. But that was for you. Because you and my dad were so gutted. But then everyone started going around as if we should have this, like, grief. As though a person had died.
A person did die?
But it never even felt real in the first place.
I don't believe you.
What? Is she the only one allowed to be honest in this house?
Stranger.
Sorry, I should have been back to you sooner.
I was beginning to think that your phone had been cut off or something.
Yeah, I got that impression from the message.
Well, do you want a drink? Oh, me, Nan and Ray, they've both gone out.
Aye, why not? Another night on your lonesome, eh? Must get you down.
I'm never in.
Oh, bet you don't tell Tim that.
Who's Tim?
You mean you don't write to him every day?
I tried to call, but I told him that I had to keep the line free. So as my agent could phone me up. So, what happened to all this work that you promised me?
I never promised you, to be fair. But I have found it hard placing you. Your height's a problem.
Well, I haven't shrunk since you took me on.
No, I always knew catwalk was out of the question, but, well, I was hoping for more interest from, you know, catalogue or promotional work even. There's just a real lull at the moment.
I figured that one out for myself.
Yeah, the only work we're really getting through the books is glamour. Now, I'm talking top end of the market. It's swimwear into glamour, nothing seedy.
Sure.
And you don't box yourself in doing that sort of stuff, you know. You can always go for fashion jobs once the market starts picking up. But for the time being...
It's flipping out or on out.
Well, yeah.
Lost. Thought you were never coming home.
Yeah.
Ironic, isn't it? I'm not good enough in the visit and surgery, but come late night call outs, they can't get enough of me.
Have a glass of wine. Bit of good news. Jackie must have had a word with Katie and Clint, because when I came in this evening, they'd done a massive shop.
Great.
Yeah, it's all spaghetti hoops and white bread, but it's the thought that counts. Unless you want spaghetti on toast for supper.
I think I'm going to have an early night.
Do you want company?
Hiya.
Hiya. Chips?
And curry sauce.
You don't like their curry?
No, but you do.
You can go now if you want, Paul.
Can I? Nice one.
Look, I'm sorry if I upset you, but I'm not sorry for what I said.
What you said was fair dues. I was thinking about it from my point of view and Josh's. I wasn't thinking about the baby, but you do know I'd love him.
Oh, I wasn't saying you wouldn't love him. You're a fantastic mother. I wouldn't have given it a second thought if I didn't believe that.
So you have thought about it then?
Yeah. And then I thought about Fred.
Mm. I mean, you might go to Brazil.
Mm. On holiday. If I could find some soft touch with plenty handbag to bankroll me.
I mean to live.
I have enough trouble speaking English. I can't kid myself. It's the love of my life, but sometimes I find myself wondering if we'll ever be together. Do you know what immigration are like?
You never know.
I could have conned you, Bev. Made out like I didn't want to get involved and then monopolised the kid. But what's the point of that? We both need to know where we stand. See, you say you love me enough to bring my baby into the world. Well, that's the easy bit.
You've never been in labour, obviously.
I'm serious. You'd have me baby, but do you love me enough to let me help you bring it up?
Boo! What do you want?
You, actually.
What, on a slab?
Don't tempt me.
Yeah, we haven't got all night.
All right. You've got a deal. Darren's been put through enough.
And I haven't.
Like I said, don't tempt me. You can have the £1,000.
I said two in cash.
One in cash. But we want a written affidavit. That's a letter, sweetheart, saying that nothing untoward happened between you and Dr. Darren. It was a mistake. Well?
Well, I've heard of stand by your man, but this is just ridiculous.
So you're not interested?
Well, I'll give it some thought.
Yeah, well, don't think too hard, because the offer won't be there forever.
I'll sleep on it, then.
Please yourself.
I will do.
Came out wrong before. I'm sorry.
Well, I'm sorry and all for winding you up.
I didn't mean, I didn't care. Just hard to understand what you were going through.
I should have realised that.
And then when I seen you, you know, getting on with it so well, I just thought if I mentioned it, I'd just be dragging it all up again.
Doesn't need dragging up. It's with me all the time. And you're right. It wasn't a person. It wasn't like losing you or your dad. But all these weeks I spent wondering what he or she was going to be like. I'd imagine them dead sporty like you, with a Dells colouring and your dad's sense of humour. But it was real for me. When that baby died, all my dreams died as well.
I'm sorry.
Cheer up. Have a chip.
Last one. You have it. That's how much I love you.
Well, it's nice to hear it sometimes. John boy.
I don't think you've really thought this through. I mean, like, I won't be diving in no closet for parents' evening.
Well, you could if you wanted to.
And you'd have to face some flack.
Oh, dare to be different. I made a career out of it.
I mean it. Name calling, windows put in. It could happen. It could all happen.
We can handle it, can't we?
Yeah. Could the kids?
Yeah, they could. Because we teach them how to stand up to bullies and bigots.
Lance, if you don't think your kids are going to make the world a better place, well, then you shouldn't have any.
Oh, nicest thing you've ever said.
So, if I said, yes, I do love you enough to share a baby with you, what would you say? Would you consider it?
Well, I'd have to talk to Fred.
And what if he said yes? Because he might do. What would you say then?
Well, yeah. Oh, my. I just said it. I just said I'd be a dad.
This calls for a toast.
Oh, just orange for me.
You can't toast with just juice. Here you are. Now, all that about the turkey baster. It was just talk, wasn't it?
Actually, no.
But you couldn't, could you? If we decided to go for it.
I thought we just did.
But would you be able to go for it?
Babe, you're the nearest thing to Joan Crawford I'm ever going to meet.
See ya.
Well, seems like you specialise in making false claims.
How much weight have you lost?
4.5 stone. 19.5 counting the hour, fella.
Excuse me. I'm looking for Leanne Powell.
So you made it then?
Yeah.
Welcome to Liverpool.
And that's Friday's Brookside at 8. Next tonight on 4 Bald Facts About Hair Loss, a devastating condition known as alopecia. And we've all got a 1 in 50 chance of getting it. Embarrassing illnesses, coming up next.
Cheers.
I think it's time for taste soup of the day.
So, what do you reckon Fred's gonna say?
Not exactly something you can leave on an answer phone, is it? Oh, by the way, when me and my fag egg mates are thinking of having a bambino.
Shh, careful.
I'm the soul of discretion, thank you.
Oh, is broccoli it still?
Mm. She's got a mouth like a clown's pocket. Mm.
For a minute. What have I done now? It's what you're not doing. She wants more than a shampoo and set. Look, I don't do chit-chat. Well, you're in the wrong job.
Is it Tim?
No, I'm worried. Where's the fire?
Wrong element. Do you know my new widescreen telly? It's only bobbing round my front room on 3 inches of water.
No, how come?
Global warming. It's been raining cats and dogs for over 2 days.
In Heighton?
I just got it lovely enough.
Emily, stick the kettle on, love.
That ozone doesn't bear thinking about.
The fire brigade out?
Police, camera crews, the full Monty.
TV crews?
Well, a photographer from the Mersmore came round and he took a snap of me wading in the kitchen with me skirt hitched up.
Oh, my 12:15's here. I'm coming now, love.
Gonna do? The knicker party's knackered.
I've been more worried about my furniture.
But our Amber will have me guts for garters.
If she's that bothered, let her host it.
She can't. Because of the environmental health, you know. Oh, die. She was banking on that money. If only I could find another venue.
If only. You know where we keep the tea bags. Have you been hacking at that fringe again? Oh, I don't know. I feel queasy. You know, I reckon it was that soup.
You do look a bit clammy.
Pale. And like Snow White.
Oh, a little sleep wouldn't go amiss, you know, just an hour.
I'll wake through my lunch. I reckon she should get her head down.
Go on, then. Have you got the nicest brother in the world, or what?
I know. I'll make it up to you.
Your place would be perfect. And Sarah's mate, Steve and Marty, are out training.
I know, but...
Yeah, then they'll be going to the alehouse afterwards. They'll roll in 4 sheets to the wind.
I fancied a quiet night in by the telly.
A night, yeah? A Friday night? No? Oh, go on. We'll provide the music, the drinks, the nibbles. You get 10% commission and I get to keep me scalp.
Amber's your half-sister, you know, not your keeper. Go on, then.
Oh, I knew you wouldn't let me down. Anyway, I better get back to me soggy carpets.
I wouldn't worry, sir. Just claim off the insurance, eh?
Hey, Di, you know what they're like in the North End, don't you? They think Manor Park's the other side of the world. You couldn't round up a few girls, could you?
Anything else?
You are a lifesaver. Anyway, Amber will drop the gear off later. Toodaloo!
No, she wasn't feeling too well, so we sent her home.
It's not just the dust that gets everywhere. Andy has to keep washing that mat around the toilet.
Mm.
Thought Mike's aim was bad.
Oh, poor old Lanthea, ain't he? Deep in work his week.
Oh. It looked nice, though. Did they ever finish it?
Oh, Casa Bevna. I really thought my ship would come in.
Didn't it still feel like Dee Dee's house?
Nah. Not once I'd lashed Ron's Brian Island gym jams, no. That terrible static on his head. It's like sleeping with Ken Dot.
What do you want?
Manners. Got a little something for you.
Yeah. Well, your time it is even worse than your taste in men. Is it my turn to do the landing again?
Right, I've measured the bedroom.
Oh, great stuff.
And I can't envisage any problems with your housing benefit.
Thanks. See ya.
Well, seems like you specialise in making false claims.
Half counting it out, fella.
I can't get over it. I can't believe Cheryl never said anything.
I can. Do you know she's one jealous little cow here? Hey, you've got a nice place, haven't you?
How'd you lose the weight?
Well, I jibbed the gin. Started walking down the quickie for me ciggies. Then I tried this peeling arter and all. But it was £8 an hour for some tree hugger to tell you to lie on your back and imagine your belly buttons being sucked up through the floor. I said, look, love, I'm not being funny, but do I look like I've got a welly on my head? The only thing I could see being sucked in was my ordained gyro down the drain.
I can't get over it. You look like a new woman.
Oh, cheers. I managed to keep it off and all. 97% don't. I eat healthy and all. All audible. But I'm regular as clockwork. Which reminds me, how's cousin Jackie?
A carpet salesman?
Yeah, that's just what you need when the rug's been pulled from under you.
What's in the envelope?
Well, it was £1,000, and now it's your confession.
Oh, so Mrs. Moral Highground had only come round to bribe me then?
No, I came round to buy the truth. But yeah, now I'm more than happy to resort to bribery.
Your dirty perv of a fella touched me up.
Oh, shut up.
He groped me.
In your dreams. Now, listen. Either you admit it's all lies or I'm going to go down to the DSS and I'm going to sing like a lark.
I'll think about it.
Could always talk to Lance.
Oh, what a couple, eh? A blackmailer and a dirty old perv. Mud's dictionary and Dr. Darren. He's covered in it.
Sign it.
I have to do the double because my life is a struggle. Not all of us can go running back to Daddy for handouts, you know.
Yeah, but it's not your thieving that I object to, Leanne. It's the lying. The really malicious lies. Sign it. Like you said, you dragged Darren through the mud. Now you can drag him out of it.
Still doing her telephone voice, is she?
Jackie Corkill. She's great, you know.
You look for the good in everyone, you. Believe her husband's flipped his lid. Time bomb him. And his new Mark brothers. Billy's tasty mind. Frankie was murdered. And by all accounts, their eldest is a lesbian.
You've done your homework.
Oh, my people pierce and die. Always have been. Haven't got any salad cream, have you? Owned a petrol station, she told our Cheryl. Then we find out she's skivving away in a knobbly blue jumper.
Tight ward still owes me catalogue money from 1979. Satin camisole, dusty pink. Oh, 155 for 12 weeks. She only stumped up 3 instalments. Then me and Tony had a shotgun wedding. My mother had murder with her at the day do. Then Jackie Tane's on the waterworks. Jimmy Nuts Tommy. The prawn cocktails went flying everywhere. And my dad had an angina attack. I'm not one to forgive and forget.
Cheryl reckons 7:30 for the knicker party.
Perfect. I'm a bit of a charlatan, you know, vis-a-vis your lingerie. Of course, when I have a nice off, it's kettle on, slippers on. My savvy's off, my bra off. And after I've unleashed the beasts, I get into a pair of old tracky bottoms and a T-shirt, you know, and let them jiggle all about a bit.
Right.
Favourite night in, those curled up on the sofa with the big bar of chocolate.
Me too.
Especially when the Reds are at home. What day does your bin men come?
Thursday.
Well.
I don't like surprises.
Oh, you'll love this one.
Can we at least take a table? I feel like I'm on display.
Yeah, you are. Exhibit A, an innocent man. Oh, feeling any better?
Not really, no.
Go and take a pew and I'll bring you over to the latte.
Hang on a minute, Lance. I think that Leanne's got an announcement to make of me.
Ignore her and him, and I don't know how you can carry on like nothing's happened.
I'm dropping the allegations.
Has he been threatening you?
No. I just don't think it's fair to put Vic through all this pain.
What is this?
So, he's gonna walk then, free to fondle the next one.
I never fondled anybody.
As a 21st century woman, I am not prepared to inflict pain on a fellow sister.
Surely there's a bit more to it than that, Leanne.
There might have been some miscommunications.
As in, you've lied?
Don't be bamboozled, Leanne.
Well, I think maybe with hindsight, I might have just overreacted a titsy bit.
Overreacted?
Well, it was only a seed of doubt. But you know, from like small seeds and acorns and all that caper.
No, I'm sorry, that's not good enough. You're gonna have to tell them you lied from the start. Tell them, Leanne.
I made it up.
You lied?
Lance, I was stressed out.
I never touched you. Tell them.
Never told you me.
Truth always wins in the end.
Is that a fact?
Yeah. It's over. Now you can get back to doing what you do best.
Yes. My vocation.
I'd never lie to you.
I spend my life defending you, Leanne. Telling people that they've got you wrong.
Will you stop that flaming scraper?
You lied to me. To me.
No! Lance, I have lied to everyone but you. I had to pretend I've made enough for Victoria's sake. Lance, I'd rocked a faith in Darren, a knight in shining armour.
What about my faith in you?
Because I knew that you and me, I knew we'd be okay. Because I've got the truth on my side. Well, Vic, I had to lie to protect her. What else could I do, eh? Lance, she said, if the allegations about Darren were true, and she said she'd top herself.
Be with you in a minute, love. Are you for spitting feathers out there?
There you go.
Have you sugared it?
No.
Emily. Oh, Emily.
I'm worried.
It is Tim, isn't it?
I mean, I'm not even let me speak to him no more. He's not allowed to phone the house. I miss him so much.
course you do. I'll tell you what. If you promise to crack a smile for the punters, I can ring you here.
Honest?
Late afternoons, when it's quiet.
Oh, dear, that's brilliant. Thank you.
I can't just pretend nothing's happened. Even though nothing has happened.
Hey, why don't we chuck a sickie for a week? Change the scene would do good.
I think more like a change of career.
Wow. Because of Leanne.
Oh, there's plenty more where she came from. They're probably queuing up around the block.
Look, you're disillusioned. I mean, it's understandable.
I'm disappointed in them, in the people that I'm trying to help. Yeah. I thought they'd look up to me. You know, he's a grafter. He really cares for his patients. He really listens.
That's all true.
Is it?
Yeah. I mean, you've kept your sanity and your compassion. And you're not an alky, and that's pretty good going in your profession.
I am steeped in cynicism. I am constantly checking up on patients, wondering if they're trying to trip me up, or have they got pound signs in their eyes.
Well, that's the lovely Leanne's legacy.
No, it's before Leanne. It's insidious. And, you know, I mean, 2-3 years ago, I used to make straight diagnoses. Now I hedge my bets. It looks like X. It could be Y or Z. I'm afraid to call a spade, because if you put one foot wrong, you're public enemy number one.
Right.
Poor Vic.
Oh, poor you.
Oh, I'm all right. I finally learned the meaning of sisterhood. But Vic was, you know, she'd been through the mill, what with her arm full of falling down the stairs and that. She thought she finally found happiness, someone she could trust.
And there's me thinking she just whipped out the checkbook.
Bev?
Well, who am I to shatter illusions, eh? Ruin her life?
You're a one-off. I'm so proud of you.
I must look an absolute show.
Oh. To think I doubted her.
Oh, don't be too hard on yourself. She's got form.
She's having to make out she's a liar to all and sundry. Oh, that doctor is low life.
Suppose she'll make do as an auntie. Or our baby. That is, unless you've changed your mind.
No. Let me give Fred another tinkle.
We live in a culture of blame. Suing, counter-suing. There's nothing you can do about it.
Can opt out.
Just stressed.
I just want to practice medicine. Relieve suffering. That's all I ever wanted to do.
I know. All that conniving little bitch wanted was money.
She wanted blood.
No, she wanted a grand. Scary, isn't it?
You weren't going to pay her off, were you?
Well, I didn't have to in the end. I caught her fiddling the housing benefit. She soon signed off to that. And she's over its history.
You blackmailed her?
Well, I had her over a barrel. She signed the affidavit. No money changed hands.
Oh, great! No, that's fine then. Hey, so much for the soul searching. I'm finished.
Here you go.
Oh, thanks. Agent Carl's been on.
He's got us an assignment.
No, and he doesn't reckon he will until. We really go for it.
Don't like the sound of that.
He says there's a lot of interest in our portfolios.
But?
All the potential clients are saying the same thing.
Let me guess. Whipped them off for the lads.
Bumming, isn't it?
What a blessing in disguise. That slime ball's been building up to this since day one.
I don't want to be some cheesy gay dad in a cap sleeve t-shirt. And I don't want the baby dressed head to toe in designer labels. Kids need to feel free. Get covered in paint and ketchup.
Gotta get Preggers Plays Pop first.
I know, I'm just saying. I don't want to be like the gay dad you see in magazines. Everything's shiny and perfect.
Well, I'm not having any kid of mine dressed like some pov. Anyway, let's talk turkey.
But not basters.
You're gonna have to bite the bullet.
Operation Bambino.
Rudy's? Well, it's either me and you or me and Fred.
Whichever of us. We'll both love the baby like it's our own.
I know you will. Look, do you think you're going to be able to do the deed?
Oh, yeah, if I psych myself up and get into the hetero groove.
How are you going to do that?
I'll do my taxi voice.
What's that, then?
When I don't want taxi drivers to know I'm a queg. Yeah, I'll show you. Tom, please meet. Brilliant, isn't it?
Okay, right. We're in Mellow Mellow. We've copped off, got a kebab, and now we're in a taxi on the way home.
Manor Park, please meet.
We're going down Duke Street. You brush away the hair from my face.
Maybe you could have some tahini sauce down your front.
Concentrate! Now, we're in a taxi. What next?
No offence, girl, but that can't be natural.
We've just done a partying for Zachary. These weren't like hotcakes.
Scald not. 5p got robbed. Someone was sick all over my case, and the woman from number 9 called the busies. Where is everyone?
Maybe we should have a go with the turkey baster.
That was my first ever snog with the fair of sex. Give me a chance.
What, do you think some practice would help?
Yeah, defo. Let's get back in that taxi. Right, where are we now?
Egbert Road, I think. The windows are all steamed up. The day I became a model, I promised myself I'd never do anything degrading.
Yeah, and look where they got you. Self-assembly sheds and a pound of sausages.
You're seriously considering taking your kit off?
I said I'd think about it, yeah.
Slippery slope.
But it pays really well. Aren't you even tempted?
No. He thinks he can name a price and we'll go running. Some things aren't for sale.
Excuse me. I'm looking for Leanne Powell.
So you made it then?
Yeah.
Welcome to Liverpool. The home of the Beatles.
How did it do?
Oh, nice, soft. Better than Ron for a kick-off.
I didn't know what to do with my tongue, so I thought best leave well alone.
Me and all. Do you feel any kind of attraction, even a smidgen?
Okay, let me rephrase it. Do I knock you sick?
No way, no.
That's a start. So, if you have to choose between kissing me and Jesse Chadwick...
You.
Jackie Dixon?
You div.
Katrina Evans?
Oh, now you insult me.
Lulu.
That's dead unfair. Stick to Manor Park.
Oh, he is going to be just so made up. I nearly let it slip before, you know.
What, you spoiled the surprise?
Exactly. I tell you what, why don't I lend you my keys? And then you can just go and let yourself in.
How far is it?
Oh, literally up there and that way.
Oh. I got them in Houston. Oh. Oh.
That's for the main door. And that one, right, that's for the flat.
Oh, flip a neck. He's just going to die a million deaths.
Looks lovely.
No, I said I'd host the flipping party, not wander around in the buff.
Well, you've had a drink down your neck. Better still.
No.
Not for me, thanks. I'm up early tomorrow.
Oh, Di, will you relax? You're supposed to enjoy yourself at these do's, throw caution to the wind and anything else that takes your fancy.
Just have a little sip, it'll warm the cockles of your heart. What if that's Father Pat?
Oh, well, invite him in. I've got a couple of confessions to make.
You step out of line and this party is off. She's a bit miserable, isn't she? Anyway, lambs to the slaughter.
Surprise!
Oh.
of these.
$8.99.
Go for a song.
Why don't you just stop talking in riddles? He only had to tell me it was over.
I told him I'd stick his topless modelling job.
I've not found comfort anywhere else.
Cheryl, will you leave the poor girl alone?
I think I'm gonna be sick.
It was like a knife in mortuary until the cavalry arrived.
Next up, pints of Guinness and shamrocks in tow. Davina's invading the streets of Limerick and Manchester. Love is Street Mate, coming up.
Leon and I wanted to surprise you.
Oh, the keys, of course. Oh.
But it's me who got the surprise.
Oh, I know how that must have looked, but it was only Beth.
I set off yesterday morning. Bus, train, plane, taxi. And I walk in on you kissing a woman.
Yeah, but
all you had to do was be straight with me.
I was trying to be straight with her. That's why we were snogging.
Why don't you just stop talking in riddles? You only had to tell me it was over.
Oh, babe, I said. The bad news is, yeah, we were having a little kiss. But the good news is, it was only because I was trying to get her pregnant.
Hi. Hiya. Am I glad to see you too?
The more sane people, the better.
Well, we nearly didn't make it.
Yeah, we were umming and ahhing, but then Mr. Dixon put his foot down and said there's no way he'd allow it.
So here we are. Down in one, please, ladies.
I think I'll have a cup of tea, thanks.
Oh, Lord Amber brought this special. She'd be so offended.
Amber.
Head off, sister. Pleased to meet you. Hope you brought your purses with you.
I'm just browsing. You do what you like, love. Don't be browbeaten by these two.
Oh, look.
34D. Ah, 36A. Shame.
Got the cheese straws. Excuse me.
I think you might be in the bad box, son.
Carl's been on to Emily.
Beat you.
Reckons if we want to make it, we're going to have to do topless.
No way. Give me his number.
I'll handle it, thanks.
Cheeky get. Definitely don't fancy doing topless then.
Dad? It's like a pervert. It's degrading.
I was only asking.
Come on, Shona, or we'll be late for this knicker party.
You what?
Naughty knickers. Hey, you want to be great, but she makes the effort.
Hope there's going to be no lads there.
I'll go where I want, when I want.
Why don't you two come along? Cheryl and her sister are doing the modelling for it.
Amber? No, knock that one on the head, thanks. Have a good night, Shona.
Thanks.
Let's just hope it's not too titillating or degrading, eh?
I don't think your wife would be hosting it if it was. See ya.
A baby?
That's why I've been trying to get hold of you.
Are you insane?
We can help raise a child. Our child.
Where?
Right here. Bev only lives next door.
How cosy.
Exactly. Cosy and loving. We can work our shifts around the childcare arrangements. If we get really stuck, there's even a crèche downstairs.
You two seem to have it all worked out.
We'd make brilliant dads. You know we would.
Well, I'd have to be brilliant from a distance. The other side of the world, in fact.
Love that.
I don't think so.
How much are these? $8.99. Go for the song.
More to the point, what is it?
Go on then, Seven. Do you know I must have milk tattooed on my head?
I'll have a think about it. Disgusting. I reckon Beecham would love this tat. Right up his street.
Hey, keep it
family.
What about your Jerome, Nick? Does he like frills and thrills?
I love life lacks nothing. Thank you very much.
Pray tell.
Lost.
Well, I think he's a lovely lad. A real find.
He is, yeah. He's everything to me. Enjoy it while it lasts, kid.
Oh, it'll last. Me and Jay for keeps. I've been such a selfish cow.
You haven't got monopoly on that one.
Oh, I really hit rock bottom. Even at the bottom. Even at him. He just came back at me with love.
You hang on to him, Nikki.
I will, for dear life.
Anyone with that loyalty deserves a reward. I'll five it.
Thought you'd be slaving away at the restaurant.
Max had not much choice. I threatened to walk.
Things haven't calmed down yet.
You're joking, are you? Everyone's treading on eggshells, including the customs.
Can't be good for business.
You know, if we were down south, his rudeness would be a unique selling point. Up here in the north, it's only a matter of time before he gets his head kicked in.
Still grieving for Suzanne, I suppose.
Yeah, well, he's not the only one. I mean, at least Max's grief has got some status. The ex-husband. I haven't got a title on that. I'm expected to just pick up where I left off.
Do you miss her?
Miss what might appear. I've got so many questions. I'll never know the answers.
Tasty, eh?
The nurse? Not bad, I suppose.
Get out of here. She's just 9.5, eh?
Okay then, 7. But I can take it or leave it, mate.
It's not all worked out. I told Bev I needed to talk to you first. We're in this together or not at all.
Well, that's something. What was it like?
Oh, the kiss. Bizarre. As much as I love the bones of her. Hey, you could have a go tomorrow.
Like kissing Bev?
Mm-hmm. She won't mind. It's in a good cause.
I don't want to rain on your parade, but my visa expires in 3 weeks' time.
Yeah, well, I've thought about that. No. If we're going to become full-time dads, we're going to have to find a way for you to stay in Blighty. Permanently.
I'm sure your government will welcome you with open arms.
Don't go worrying about immigration. Love conquers all.
No, I don't think. Not me, pal.
What are you doing here, Tillymint?
Mum, what about your homework?
Finished it? It's horrible upstairs. All the neighbours are laughing. It's like a social studies thing, this. The role of women in that. I reckon again, Nessie has
Katrina this. Evans is not for sale, got it?
Go ahead, Trine, you tell him.
Yeah, you heard, scumbag. Yeah, where the sun doesn't shine. Bye. I told them we're to stick as topless modelling jobs.
We've heard, can we crack on?
Do you know how many ostriches have been plucked for this little garment?
Hey, Jan, can you see if that cheesecake is defrosted in the fridge?
It's either that or your bedroom.
Come on, Dad, don't be so po-faced. Why not give Mart a little treat?
You could have that instead of commission.
No, Tar. 10% of precisely nothing will do me nicely. She's right. Come on, you miserable tightwads. Dig deep. Hey, Anne, what is this stuff? Chateau 2000.
Oh,
that chateau with a...
I think it's lovely.
Hey. Dai said he was going to ring it out. Yeah, he is. Can you keep a secret?
Can I?
When he gets old, we're going to get married.
I reckon there's hope for you on this, Yvonne.
That's if she doesn't cop off with a mousie.
Well, did you leave it?
I kissed the maid up. Told her to miss her.
It's in the bag.
How'd you make that out?
Well, she'd be made up to know that she wasn't just a one-off. I mean, things are, stuff like that's really important to a woman. Especially, like, if you've been mates for years, even better.
Well, maybe, Mart. But I think you're forgetting the fly in the ointment. He's 6'1" and older than a pool cue.
I don't want to hear any more baby talk.
Okay.
I need time to think. One of us has to. The thing that worries me most is...
I know. Immigration.
Then I haven't even had my hello kiss.
Yeah, well, that's easily remedied. After you've finished the cheese on toast. Hey, did you get that pound of Cheshire I sent?
Hmm.
Had Major in the post office. The one behind the counter's, oh, she's power mad. Said no way would a pound of cheese make it to Brazil in one piece. I'll be around there first thing to have a cook gloat.
Leanne's got your nose.
Mm, criminal, isn't it? Oh, what do you think that?
Go ahead.
Anyone for a fresh fruit?
No, thanks.
Thought you'd be telling us off.
You're joking, aren't you, little knackered?
Oh, the night's young, sweetheart.
I'll be giving Mike a bit of physio.
Oh, he'll be on soon, Rach. Sounds like he's going great guns.
You reckon? Might have pushed him right round in that wheelchair for the next 30 years.
Who'd you feel sorry for, you or him?
Our baby. All three of us. Oh, I'm sorry, it's just because I'm a bit drunk.
Sounds like you're under the cosh.
How'd you manage for the other Rach?
Well, how do you mean?
You know, going without.
I go without?
You've not found comfort anywhere else.
Cheryl, will you leave the poor girl alone?
Well, I'm exactly the same. Since my Tommy's been on the rigs, I've led the life of a nun.
Poor Max.
Mm. He's still chaotic. It's like they've never been divorced. He's living in her house, sleeping in their old bed.
That's awful sad. I bet you were up for him.
Not really. Wouldn't let anyone near, except that Jackie Dixon.
The one who sold a baby?
Mm. Don't know what Arlene sent down. Oh. Wish Arlene could find someone special. She's got so much to offer.
What's Bev's flat like?
Off its gay. Not unlike Dame Beverly herself.
Are you sure I've nothing to worry about there?
She's the original fag-ag. And me, I'm an incurable queen.
Hallelujah.
Say never.
I never would.
So if he was permanently paralysed, you could really stay faithful.
It's more to a relationship than sex.
It's the only bit I'm really interested in these days.
It's really sad.
Do I look sad?
No, just drunk.
Now, I've done the monogamy bit, pledged my undying love.
Clint?
Yeah, we were ticking along quite nicely, in love and all that. He was the one who wanted to get engaged, and he got off.
Oh, well, he obviously wasn't the right one for you.
Oh, there is no right one. It's a myth.
No, your wrong niche is out there, but you just haven't found him yet.
Oh, you have, but you haven't realised.
Oh, wouldn't that be romantic? I'm starving. I'm going to get some food.
Oh. I reckon he's just round the corner, Nisha.
Well, wherever he is, he can swivel. Men cheat, it's a given.
Not all men.
Pray she's right, love. You've got to keep them begging for more. Sorry, do you know I keep forgetting this is a knicker party?
You can't tie every bloke with the same brush.
I'm telling you, they all cheat. The 5% who don't, it's only because they haven't had a chance.
That is so cynical.
It's just sex. I've slept with blokes who are in happy relationships.
No, they can't be happy.
I'm kind of seeing someone at the moment. Purely physical, loves his girlfriend, nice, normal bloke.
Well, he's a scumbag. He's got to be.
I think you'd like him.
I beg to differ.
Like who? What have I missed? The top up. I'm just going to go back to the kitchen and see if there's another bottle.
There you go.
Can I go in the other room now? They stopped talking about sex.
Go on, then.
I thought you were staying off.
You know?
Am I, yeah? Could be another 6 years before I get pregnant, if at all. Cheers. Have you tried IVF?
Don't start me on that. I'm too old.
Hold! Blimmin' outrageous!
And although technically the Marty's kids, as far as the authorities are concerned, we've already got 3 children.
For heaven's sake.
I want a baby of my own. Of our own.
was just plain greedy.
I'd like to get down there and chin them. Patronising gets, aren't they?
And it's true. We have got three kids, three fantastic kids, and I wouldn't swap them for the world.
No, we know what you're saying, Di.
The waiting list for IVF is 2 years.
Oh, let me guess. It all boils down to money.
In one. The success rates are low enough as it is. My eggs have been round the block. Not a worthwhile investment. If it was the housing list, I could understand the need to prioritise, but wanting a baby? How can anyone say one person's needs are greater than another's?
No, it's offered set, isn't it?
We're a non-urgent case. I don't want to be on a list. More important than some poor sods, less important than others. Says who?
It's disgusting. If you waved your checkbook, you'd magically go to the top, no doubt.
Oh, yeah, who says money can't buy everything?
And there's 3 grand to go.
Oh! 3 grand. You want to get down there and flutter your eyelashes at the bank manager and stay off the pump.
Hi, love.
Oh, two fat ladies. That was the bingo.
Oh, not so fat, lady. How much have you lost?
A shed load.
What's going on in there?
Well, if I said to Nick a party, I'd probably be sued under the Trade Description Act.
Oh, I better see what Adele's on to.
Hey, do you like them? They're only 5, and I've got a size 22 left, I'm sure of it.
Then he pulled his hand out, and it was sweet.
Oh, come on, I reckon we should go to yours and check out this nicotine.
Oh, no, can we go to yours and lie low till Gerald's out the way?
Nah, come on, mate, I need to go and improve my lingerie know-how.
One more and then we're off ski.
Hey, do you know, I can still undo Di's bra with me teeth.
I don't want to know, thanks.
Is that with the front fastening?
Come ahead, lads. Let's go in there and twang some elastic.
Hey, and don't let that amber maul me.
Nor me.
Get the load of the eagles on them way, lads. AJ, we'll have to all that end up, won't we?
Same again, boys.
Yeah. Right.
Let's just say that I offer comfort and supper to a local bobby.
A very local bobby. Knocks around at the convent, does he? Well, Leo Johnson.
That was his very first.
That was Steve's first. He was really shy and sweet.
Are you sure about that, Kat?
Katrina, couldn't believe it. Made me love him even more.
Cheryl, shut up. If they're all crying, they're not buying. You're putting the muckers on the party.
Cheryl.
I know, love.
Hate him. He's a stupid busy. She's old enough to be his mum. It's disgusting.
When I was at school, I couldn't choose between Gerald Curran and Declan Goody. I named me fish after them and everything.
This is serious. I'm not some stupid 13-year-old.
I didn't say you were. But by the end of term, I'd moved on to Tim Crane. And then a posh boy called Neil Marlins.
Did you go out with any of them?
Did I, heck? Who else do you like? It must be somebody.
Quite like Peter Lamont, I suppose.
Well, there you go, then. So Leo Johnson's not the be-all and end-all.
But I really like him, Mum.
I know you do. But he can't be much of a catch if he's going around sleeping with married women, can he?
Cheryl doesn't even care about him. Everyone was laughing at him. I'd never do that.
That's why you're worth 100 Cheryls. You deserve someone special. Someone who knows your worth.
Dan, are you OK?
I think we overdid the sherry.
I am not altogether happy about you being here, madam.
You going, Gazi?
I think I'm going to be sick.
Good luck!
Clint's okay, you know. I mean, what he did to you was terrible, but...
Rachel, the Moffat's a bad news. I know it sounds like sour grapes, but believe me, Katie and Jackie want to be careful.
Look, I think you're right about what you're saying about most fellas cheating, but I'm going to make sure me and Tim work.
Oh, good luck. You'll need it.
See ya.
See ya. Bye.
What will you do when the authorities come knocking? Hide me in a cupboard?
If I have to. There's got to be a way to keep it here.
I'd forgotten how innocent you are. World of Lance.
Yeah, all the laws that keep us apart are wrong. We belong together.
Jessie must be in a really bad way up there.
What about it? I've only made 28 flaming quid.
Still, it's all knock-off, isn't it?
True enough, but...
Plus, you've made loads of new mates.
Aww, sweet.
How much more? Oh, come on, Carl, that's too tacky. Well, I might get them out, but only if you tell me how much it pays. Look, you get me a topless job and I'll do topless. Only for me? I'm not drunk. Look, me word is me bond. I'll do topless, right? I'll see you the same in the morning.
I've been sick.
Oh, get out of the way, quick!
Looks like the fall of Babylon,
isn't
it?
It was like a living fortune until the cavalry arrived.
A word in Michel Lang.
Here we go.
Come on, we're getting off.
Okay.
See ya. Why did you tell Katrina she was your first?
Well,
you're too drunk to be clever. It was Cheryl, wasn't it? You're lucky you didn't catch something.
How's your jet lag?
What jet lag?
Can't believe you went all party pooper.
I was knackered.
Sure it wasn't like your ears were burning?
As if.
No, everyone was slagging fellas off. So I started bragging about you.
But you're the old love, though.
I would trust you with me life. Only because I was drunk, like.
That Amber one's dog rough, though.
Oh, she's sound, though. Turn off like that, Misha.
Yeah.
She's been really hate. Now she's just loved them and leave them. Only without the love.
Did she say that, did she?
Mm-hmm. Sad that, isn't it? She told Katrina that she's with some fella who's got a girlfriend and reckons it suits her fine.
Right.
Must do her head in, really.
Look, can I switch this light off or what?
Mm. Like gorgeous.
Come on.
Ain't got a dark horse, aren't you, do is she?
It's not sign. It's just this.
I need more than some sort of holiday romance. I need to know what's going to happen to us.
What do you think you're playing? Not telling Nicky about us?
Could be getting beat up or anything. Sure he'll be okay.
What did you say?
Brookside returns tomorrow at 8 o'clock. Next tonight, slow, smelly and noisy, or fuel efficient and more environmentally friendly. The diesel debate on Driven. We'll be right back.
that the post end?
Yeah. Don't suppose you sent me a Valentine?
You know what I think of all that. It's just an excuse for somebody to make money. Like that flaming knicker party.
Tell our Steve. Card wasn't good enough for Trina. He's just forked out £100 to buy her a new bag.
100 quid? You're joking.
105, to be exact.
What's the matter with him, eh? More money than sense. Hello. What's this, then?
Is it Fidel?
Oh, no. This is for Master Anthony Murray.
Me?
Well, go on then, open it.
Is that the postman, do you reckon?
I don't know.
Remember what day it is?
What?
It's Valentine's Day. Are you going to have a look?
He's going to send me a Valentine's Day card. I'll just go and put the kettle on here. Shall I open it for you?
No. Oh, don't be shy. It's nice getting a Valentine.
Who says it's a Valentine's?
Go on, open it.
It's private.
Go on, Aunt. Honest, there's no need to be embarrassed.
Well? Oh, let's have a look.
Give it me.
No, Marty.
Dad!
To my darling Anthony from someone who sees you every day.
Give it me!
Hey, you're a dark horse, aren't you, is she?
Give it me!
Don't wind him up.
Tell me who she is and you can have it back.
Dad!
You're embarrassing him. Yeah, love.
Well, you must have some idea who she is.
I haven't.
That's not very nice.
Well, I don't care. I'm going to school.
You embarrassed him. I hope you didn't send it to wind him up.
Who, me? As if.
Open it then.
It might not be a Valentine card.
Well, open it. Who's it from?
It's not signed. It's just this. Nick, I've got no idea who it's from, honest.
It's off me, soft lad.
Off you? I'm sorry I didn't get you when I forgot.
It's okay. Do you want to get a kiss then? It's if you are. Who else would it be from?
I knew she wouldn't forget. But all I could send her was a longer letter. Hey, did you get one and all?
No, it's off me, Mum. Dad's been around, battered it again.
I wish that card had been for Ardell.
Isn't she a bit young for all that?
Of course she's not. She could do with a lift after last night. She had a bit of a shock.
Oh, why?
Well, you know she's sweet on Leo Johnson.
No, she is too young for him.
And he's too young for Cheryl.
What?
Yeah, she told us last night they got it together. Ardell was upset.
Cheryl and Leo? That's the woman no shame. Leo Johnson. Talk about cradle snatching.
Would you be laughing if it was our Steve?
Our Steve had run a million miles from Cheryl.
Well, that's where you're wrong. She was his first.
You're joking.
She hinted at it last night. And when I tackled our Steve, he admitted it.
He kept that quiet. The randy little...
It's not funny. He told Trina she was his first.
Well, he's probably a bit embarrassed. Him and Cheryl Smith, eh?
The thing is, he lied.
Well, he's hardly likely to own up to having her away with someone old enough to be his mother now, is he, eh?
That's not the point. He lied. And you can't build a relationship on lies.
Yeah. You're okay. Well, I think we should talk to her. Okay. See you later, Ben.
Who is that?
Katrina.
What did she want?
Oh, just a matter. Hey, look, I'm going to stay at home and do my work today. Why don't you stay here as well?
I've got lectures this morning.
Okay, well, I'll see you back here at dinner time then.
I've got work to do in the uni library, though.
Oh, I couldn't wait till tomorrow. We've got the place for ourselves.
I've got loads of work to catch up on.
Okay. Don't be getting bogged down, though. Remember, you're taking me out tonight.
Well, if I get bogged down, then I'll meet you in Bev's bar about 7, yeah?
Okay. It's still Valentine's Day. Aren't you forgetting something?
I could have put it in the post, but...
Oh, Lance, why didn't you give me a clue? I forgot all about St. Valentine's Day.
Oh, don't worry. Having you here is the best Valentine's Day I've ever had.
You made it yourself. Thank you. It's really nice. Why don't you help me finish these? Go on, eat up. There's far too many for me.
No, thanks.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
You don't fool me. What is it? Are you upset I forgot to get you a Valentine?
No.
Really?
Honest.
Well, what is it, then? Something's bothering you.
You haven't to go back in 3 weeks.
Oh, don't get so down about it, eh? Live for the day.
So depressing. 3 weeks is nothing.
All the more reason to make the best of each day. Look, today's Valentine's Day. You've got a day off. Let's do something special.
Like what?
I want you to show me around Liverpool. Show me all the things that have changed.
Is that what you really want to do?
Exactly. Just you and me, the day to ourselves. An apology for not getting you a Valentine?
Oh.
What do you say?
Great.
You haven't got that bug that's going round, have you?
You are.
We've been to the doctors?
No, just went in to see if I could find... Well, it doesn't really matter, because they weren't there. I'll see you later, eh?
Used to like this game before coming here.
I know, it's boring unless you're playing for money.
So why don't we make it a bit interesting and play for something? How's about phone cards?
I gotta give me mum a ring tonight, so I need all I've got.
Right, Dutton. Fancy doing a favour for me?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks for she and your shelling a bit.
Yeah, no problem.
What favour's that?
Keep your voice down, will you?
Yeah, what is it? It's not what I think it is it?
He wants me to read a letter off his bed.
He can't read.
Yeah, well, just keep that to yourself, eh? Because if he finds out I told anyone, he'll kill me.
Hey, we just started the game here. Can't he wait?
You're mad? I'm not messing him about.
I don't even know why you're that scared of him, you know? He's not that bad.
Yeah, well, you haven't been here as long as I have you? Is it a Valentine?
Dunno. Yeah. First letter she sent since I've been inside. Is it a Valentine?
No, it's an outlet.
What's so funny?
Nothing.
Go on and read it.
What are you waiting for?
What? Read it?
Dear Stewie, I'm very sorry for not writing, but I've got to tell you now because I can't leave it any longer without feeling bad. I'm finishing with you because I'm sick of all...
Are you taking...
No, that's what it says. She's finishing with you.
What did you say?
Craig? Craig?
Mr. Jones, quick!
In the stockroom. Emily!
Come in.
Did your fella manage to find you?
Find me?
He was coming out the walking centre this morning. I thought he was looking for you. Aren't you so well?
Fine.
Oh. Must have got it wrong. Bang on time, Mrs. Lawson. Can I take your coat?
All right. Katrina's told me what that car fella's trying to do.
Yeah, and what's that?
Don't come the innocent. I know that he's asked Katrina to do topless photos. I'm not having you get involved in all that.
No.
I know you. Has he asked you yet?
No. He's only asked Katrina because he wants to get rid of her.
What do you mean?
Well, you only have to look at her. I mean, she's so 1990s.
Hang on, it was only, what, 14 months ago, not 100 years?
Look, he doesn't like her image, so he knew that if he asked her to do topless, then she'd do one.
What if he asks you?
He won't.
Please, don't get involved.
Nicky, he's not like that.
I know that you're trying to get money together for when Tim comes out. Who knows what you do?
What do you think I am?
I'm just saying.
Yeah, well, don't.
How's your mate? Have you heard any news from the Aussie?
Concussion. Broken ribs. Busted nose. He'll live.
I heard he fell down the stairs. Right.
Clumsy or what, eh?
Yeah.
There you go.
Everyone I've spoken to is off out somewhere nice tonight. Have a look if I get an hour or two in front of the telly.
Me and all.
Oh, love. You must be missing him. Did you send him a valentine?
Yeah.
That'll cheer him up.
He sent me a really big letter as well.
That's nice. How's he doing? Didn't he say?
He never talks about being in there. Oh, I know he could be going through hell. He could be getting beat up or anything.
Sure he'll be okay. Do you know when he's coming out? Don't they get out early if, you know, good behaviour?
That's what I'm worried about. My nan won't let me visit him. I hope he rings here tonight. He could be getting into trouble or anything.
I'm sure he'll be fine.
I didn't ask Steve come home for this tea.
He's taking Katrina to some new Thai restaurant.
For Valentine's Day? What's he going to do on her birthday? Give her a trip on the QE2?
I never got treated like that.
We never had the money.
I'm only kidding.
That Steve must have money to burn. 80 quid to get his hair dyed. It's crazy.
Are you ready for a romantic evening?
What, tonight?
When the kids went out, Ardell said we could have a romantic evening on our own.
Well, where's he gone? Has our aunt gone to meet the girl who sent him the card?
I'm surprised he's still speaking to you.
But has he gone to meet her?
He's gone to the church. Dell's at Michelle's.
Then a romantic evening might be a good idea.
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure.
Who's been in myself? Not me.
Don't look at me. I haven't been anywhere near it.
I'm telling you, not to answer me.
It tastes better when it's free from Bev. Cheers to a perfect St. Valentine's Day.
Except you're going home.
Tonight, I'm going home with you.
You know what I mean.
Why don't you forget all that? Enjoy life now, this second.
I can't. It's so frustrating. I mean, we're not criminals. Why can't you just live here? It's not like you're a threat to the country.
But I have to accept the law.
Yeah, well, the law's stupid.
Please. Don't spoil the day. As far as I'm concerned, it's been perfect.
I know. But I need more. I need to know there's a future for us.
We'll have a future. I promise you.
Yeah, that's only words. I need more than some sort of holiday romance. I need to know what's going to happen to us.
What are you doing? Get off!
Get here!
Let me go out tonight! You get off me! Come on, why am I so mad? Get off me!
Where'd you get this from, you Robin Gett?
It's got nothing to do with me. Honest.
Surprise visit on Valentine's night, who'd have guessed it?
Where have you been? I've called around 3 times already.
Oh no, I had the day off.
Never mind that. What do you think you're playing? Not telling Nikki about us?
I didn't tell Nikki. I told some people at the party and I didn't mention any names, so what's the problem?
Well, could I have looked her in the face last night or this morning? What if she finds out?
Look, I don't play games. I wouldn't tell her in a million years.
Anybody at that stupid Nikki party could have put 2 and 2 together.
You're getting paranoid. If you can't cope with the guilt, you shouldn't have taken the goodies, should you?
Well, what exactly did you tell them?
Do you want a beer? I do.
Nisha, tell me what exactly.
Oh, we were swapping experiences, that's all. It just so happened that mine were a bit more exciting than most of theirs.
Fine. Got it all under control. Just count the days till I get out now, Em. And then me and you can do whatever we want.
Are you really all right, though?
Yes. It's easy. In fact, I'm really starting to get the hang of it in here.
And don't worry about money. I'm going to earn as much as I can. And when you get out, we'll be laughing.
Was that the right time of the month?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I've stopped checking.
But I thought, would you give me the come on for a romantic evening and all that? Why?
Don't you ever get sick of doing it to order?
Well?
I know I do.
But if we don't?
We're stuck, aren't we? If we do it like we used to do when we both felt like it. How long will that take me to get pregnant again?
So we'll just have to keep doing it to order?
But I need more than that. I feel like we'll never get pregnant if we carry on the way we are.
Well, let's go and see the doctor and push it with the IVF thing, eh?
There's no point.
Why not, love?
Because you know it's rationed out and I'm too old. They won't let us do it.
Well, we can try and talk them into it, can't we?
We're kidding ourselves. If we're going to get anywhere, I'll have to go private.
Do you know how much that'll cost?
No, but I can find out. I can't wait any longer. I want a baby.
So, if anyone's made a mistake, it's you by going into the walk-in centre.
That could have been about anything.
So could my story at the knicker party. They probably thought I was fibbing anyway.
I hope so.
So you don't have to get paranoid. Your guilty secret's safe with me. So you may as well get off back home.
I don't want to. I don't.
Man of Parks, the ID.
Look who I found on Lime Street Station.
Hiya. I don't know what we're gonna do.
Dad,
just one last time. That's all I'm asking.
No Brookside next Wednesday, but there will be an hour-long episode next Tuesday. Brookside's Lance, played by Mickey Poppins, steps out from behind the bar and joins us for a natter in a few minutes. Log on to channel4.com/talk.